tell him? What's your message to AJ?
Keep doing what you're doing, champ. Lights out, baby. All day.
Now, James, you did something that very, very few people did in the history of boxing. You won championships from 160 all the way to heavyweight. Do you think anyone could ever do that in reverse, going down from heavyweight to 160?
I think I can do it.
You can do it back?
Yeah, I can do it
so
back.
So you want the winner of Canelo Jacobs?
The easy win.
Who wins that fight, by the way?
I had both of them, but I think Jacobs is going to pull it out.
You think Jacobs is going to win?
Yes.
Shocker.
Yes.
Amir Khan Crawford?
I like, once again, I like both fighters, but, you know, Terrence Crawford, he's at the top of his game right now.
Who's pound for pound king right now? Is it Spence? Is it Crawford?
Who?
Earl Spence. He just fought Mikey. 47,000 people showed up.
And what that mean?
It means that people were interested in seeing him fight.
Let me tell you something. Spence is a good fighter. I think I had he's a good fighter. But, you know, he can't, you know, you can't judge a book by its cover. You know, every time all you so-called boxing experts keep on saying, label this guy the next best one, this great one, and then all of a sudden he gets flattened. And y'all like fools. So I'm saying, until Spence step up and fight Terrence Crawford or Thurman, don't even talk about him being the best fighter in the world.
How about
but he's a good fighter.
He's a great fighter, champion.
No, not great. I'm a great fighter. I'm great. He a good fighter.
He's undefeated champion. James, I think he's the most
important
guy.
Let me tell you something. You reporters are so foolish. Y'all keep on labeling people great and they ain't did shit.
So, James, what do fans tell you when they see you? You're very popular these days. You were at the Fan Expo last year. People were going crazy for you.
The fans are great. They show me them but love. You know what I'm saying?
Wherever you go.
Everywhere I go, I love it. I love my fans back. I'm glad everything happens over the years I was fighting. And I really appreciate them.
You know what's one fight I wish we got to see, but we never saw?
We met with Roy Jones.
No.
You know me.
Not that one. That's another one. I met you at Rampage. I wanted to see that one because he wanted to get into boxing.
He didn't want to. He if he could. All he had to do was sign a contract. Pop. Pop.
I didn't hear you. I'm sorry.
No.
What do you think about Roy Jones and Anderson Silva in boxing?
Where?
They were talking about it. I don't think it would happen. Would that fight never happen with you and Roy?
You ask Roy.
I will.
Ask Roy. Hey, look. I'm the only one who would ever get rematched to me. You feel me?
You know why?
Yeah, you know why.
But he was a plus on point also, just like you. Moved up from 160 to heavyweight.
Yeah, but he ran right down. He tried to, at least. You know, good. I'm not mad.
Are you familiar with Gervonta Davis, Tank Davis?
He's a little
21-0, 20 knockouts.
I like watching him because he punches.
He puts people to sleep?
Yeah.
He broke a nose off a hook. You don't always see that.
That's good. I like that.
If he fights Ryan Garcia, who wins?
Tank wins. By now. Ryan Garcia, I ain't ever seen a fight, but from what I see how his record is built, he's blown up.
Really?
Thank you, man.
Thank you, James. God bless. Good meeting you. Good meeting you, man. Thank you, man. Is it cool if I take a picture
with you?
Ellie, can you do
Of course. A favor? Hey, he's a big boxing fan, James. Quiz
him. Ask him a question about boxing.
Who?
Yeah.
Who is
that guy? All right, 1, 2. You gotta ask him a good question. That's a weak one. Nobody knows me.
Who is the only guy to win the middleweight championship? Will always be the middleweight championship and win and stay at heavyweight.
A legend right here.
And beat Holyfield. Let me ask you mathematics. If Holyfield beat Mike Tyson twice and you stopped Holyfield, what would happen if you fought Mike?
You know, everybody know I'm not him out.
But that never happened.
I've told him time and time. You gotta say, Mike, you know if I fight you? you want me to ask you out?
But it never happened, right? That would have been a... John, that would be a huge fight if he fought Mike.
It would have been a huge fight.
But what happened? It never panned out over to you? Why?
Never could come together on film.
Don King kept him away?
Yeah, well, no, it's just he had different people handling him. We just never could come together.
Same thing with the rematch with Roy? Roy Jones,
same thing with James Tony too. We just could never get it. Roy and James are good friends now.
Yeah.
They're good friends.
Roy's a great dude.
And you know, it never happened. Faith came into it. So Faith said, you know, that's it.
Quick question, James. What? Really quick.
Man,
we're in a barbershop. Check this out.
I gotta go, man.
Is that alive over there? Is that alive?
It's a turtle.
What is that?
That's his.
Let's see it. What is it? Is your toupee?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Hey, whoop his ass.
Hey, kick him out.
He looks like Mr. Furley from Three's Company.
Oh, he calls you Mr. Furley. He calls you Mr. Furley from Three's Company.
What are we doing? A group picture?
Yeah.
Come on in.
Hold on, one more.
Wait.
Got it.
One more.
Hold on. Got it.
Thank you, JT.
Pound 1, 2, and 3 in boxing.
Bud.
Terrence Crawford. Do you go with Joshua? Do you go with Joshua 2? Do you go with Spence? Do you go with Mikey? Do you go with Canelo? Lomachenko? Usyk? Usyk's doing big things. He's moving up to heavy. What do you undisputed?
Terrible.
What do you mean? Cruiserweight. Dominated.
Terrible.
Moving up to heavyweight now.
Terrible. We'll see.
How will he do as a heavyweight? I think he'll do good. He's a great boxer. Okay.
See, that's the reason why you are a reporter. Because y'all don't know shit. Y'all think I know shit, but y'all don't know nothing.
You don't think he's pound for pound, top five?
Who?
Usyk.
No.
Where do you have him on your pound for pound list?
I don't even pay attention to the stuff y'all you talking about pound for pound, because if there had not been a true pound for pound fighter since the late 2000s, late 1990s, and so forth.
They did a movie about you, right?
Yeah, well,
but it wasn't your name in the movie, right?
It was
the character
name
wasn't his name?
Right.
Yeah. Why did they do that? But it was your story.
Because they didn't pay me.
It was inspired by
James Toney, but and the guy wore your trunks. He was supposed to be you, but it wasn't you?
No.
That's messed up.
We have a TV show coming out. We have a movie coming out. We have a docudrama coming out. So everybody will see the real JT. How I am. I'm about life, love, having fun. But if you piss me off, it made me mad. We got problems. We got a big problem. But other than that, I love everybody.
You know, I talked to Rashad Holloway today. Do you know Rashad?
Who's that? Oh, yeah.
He used to spar Manny Pacquiao a lot. And he told me that when he sparred Ruslan, he saw black flashes. I said, what do you mean? Usually you're supposed to see white flashes. He goes, no, the lights went out. I said, like James Toney? He said, yes. When you hit people, the lights went out. They didn't pay the light bill.
It's proof in the pudding. Look at that. This morning I got up, I got on Facebook, and some fool had the audacity to say that one of the China brothers could beat me. I laughed. The China boys, they wouldn't last. They're champions now, but back in my day, hell no.
The fight we will have to see. Pops, what do you think? Charlo, one of the twins against James. Would it be a huge fight, pay-per-view fight?
Back in the day.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Anybody today do you think would have given you a great fight?
No.
Not Canelo?
No. Definitely. All right.
Triple G?
No. No.
Andre Ward?
No.
68, 75?
No.
You and Tyson Fury? You and, no, Fury no? What do you think of Fury?
All right.
He doesn't like me that much, but that's okay. Some people just don't like you, right? That's life. Who should he fight next? He had a draw with Wilder.
Wilder.
A rematch? And who wins the rematch?
Toss up.
Toss up. I think he's going to fight that Pulev guy next. The guy who kissed the girl. The Bulgarian guy. We'll see. He probably would win that one. Ain't doing much. Take a step back. Cause it's Ellie's setback. Saw Khali Malinazi slap Conor McGregor's friend Artem Lobov. Was it a real slap?
That was a weak ass slap.
No, that was a real slap.
That was a weak slap. I'll tell you a slap.
Hold on, we need someone to hold the phone.
You want to see a slap?
Hold on. Now, I gotta ask you this. What would James Toney do if someone slapped him like that in a face-off?
It ain't happened.
Never happened?
Everybody talk about it, but y'all saw what happened with my fuck right there, Booker.
He pulled out a machete, you pulled out a gun.
That was Iron Barkley.
Oh, sorry. That was Barkley? Yeah. You won that fight.
Of course.
I saw it. The announcers in that fight didn't give you a chance. They kept downplaying you the whole fight.
Everybody wants you there to this day. It don't bother me. Excuse me. It don't bother me because I know I've done. I know I'm one of the best of all time to ever do it. And nobody today will be able to do what I did.
Winning championships from 160 to heavyweight against the ropes, shoulder roll.
It'll never happen again.
Khali Malinazi, Conor McGregor. Who would win that fight in a boxing ring?
Who?
Conor McGregor, the UFC superstar, and Khali Malinazi, two division champion.
A draw.
What do you say, Pops? Who wins? Khali or Conor?
Depends on what the rules is.
Boxing, straight boxing.
Oh,
Khali. Peppers him with shots all night, the jab. Khali has a good jab?
He does.
Probably
got a good movement.
Did you happen to see Spence and Mikey, James, the fight?
I saw a fight. Spence was too big for him.
But he dared to be great.
Yeah, he tricked me by committing. Because he's doing things that everybody's scared to do.
Hey, what's up?
It's
true.
Canelo. All y'all heroes.
Well, Canelo just mentioned...
No, Canelo didn't mention shit.
He told me that he wants to fight Kovalev in the future. Sergey Kovalev, 175.
He's lying.
You don't think that will happen? It might.
If he did, he'd get knocked out. Like he's going to get knocked out May 5th.
You think Danny would knock him out? They're fighting May 4th.
May 4th.
Yeah. What about Lomachenko? What do you think about him?
Good fighter.
Talented.
Very talented fighter.
Clarissa Shields, who's from Flint, Michigan, is fighting Lady Hammer from Germany.
Good fight. Hey. Clarissa Shields, she's a good fighter. I respect her. Chrissy Hammer, she's a good fighter. I respect her. I ain't never seen a fight. Maybe the best woman.
Why are they like that? Well, how come UFC fighters talk good smack, but boxers?
Man, UFC fighters do not talk good smack.
Yeah, they do. I think
they're weak. Yeah, what they need to do is go to my school and go get my vocabulary.
Who's your...
No. I was like no other. I went over the balance. If you talk shit, you get dealt with.
But they're two brothers, Nick Diaz and Nate Diaz. Yeah. They love you. You always told me good things about you, and they talk and they back it up.
Good guys.
They could box too. You know, Nate's undefeated in boxing.
I heard.
And Nick's 1-0, and Nate wants to box, but he can't get out of a UFC contract.
That's good. That's good.
He would do good in boxing.
Yeah.
He sparred Andre Ward, did very well.
I heard. But you know, we're here with Ellie Setback.
Reporting. So life's been good? You've been living in Detroit for a while, right?
Yeah. I'm back coastal. I come home for 4 weeks, go back home for the rest of the time. Then come back here for 4 weeks. I'm good. It's cold as hell, but you know what? I enjoy it.
Have you heard of Kubrat Pulev?
Who's that?
Have you heard of Kubrat Pulev?
Yeah.
Ivanov's guy.
Yeah.
Some girl in... The Bulgarian. Some girl interviewed him, James, and in the end of the interview, he kissed her. And now she wants to sue him for like $1 million or something.
He must have gave her something.
Well, no. After she partied with them, after the kiss, she partied till 6 a.m. and all kinds of crazy things happened.
Whoa.
Yeah, you got to see the pictures on that film.
Yeah.
The internet.
There's more stuff that haven't come out.
Wow. That's crazy.
Yeah, things are crazy. But you guys went to Russia with Ivanov.
Yeah.
No. We go with
him. And Buddy McGirt was there too.
Yes, Buddy Fat Ass was there. Hey, y'all didn't know this. Buddy is a black leprechaun.
What does that mean?
A black leprechaun.
Is it a good luck charm?
Something like that.
Why do they call him Little Bud? That's his nickname.
No, you talking, that's the wrong one. You talking about Chance Crawford.
No. Buddy told me yesterday, because his dad was Bud. He told me his dad was a street guy, and he was Little Bud.
With hair like that, ain't no way in hell he was Little Bud. You feel me? That hair is so huge, ain't no way in hell they call him little anything. I'm telling you.
Head of the class.
Hey, he is head and shoulders over the rest. Buddy McGurk, my lover, that's my dude, man.
Great trainer, great person.
Great trainer. Hey,
now with Coppola's looking great with them.
Oh, yeah, but you know, whoever Buddy's with, he gonna turn around. He's gonna turn him around no sooner than later. You know?
Ain't doing much. Take a step back. Cause it's LA setback.